Professor Dave here. Let's take some derivatives.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we made the connection between the concept of differentiation and the act of taking the derivative of a function, and we even derived the power rule. Being able to connect all of these concepts will give us a dramatically enhanced understanding of what it is to do calculus and why we need to do it. But the fact of the matter is, there are times where we simply have to know an algorithm and be able to use it to get correct answers. So whether or not the previous tutorials were of help to you, it's now time to practice using the power rule to take the derivative of various polynomial functions, something that every calculus student will absolutely have to be able to do. As we said, the power rule tells us that in order to take the derivative of some function involving a positive integer exponent, we just pull the exponent down to become a coefficient, and then reduce the exponent by 1. So the derivative of x squared is 2 times x to the 1, or simply 2x. At this point, let's introduce another type of notation. When we write d over dx, this notation implies differentiation. It means that we are differentiating something with respect to x, which is the same thing as taking the derivative of something. So just as f prime of x means the derivative of f of x, d over dx followed by some function means to take the derivative of that function with respect to x. So in short, f prime of x is completely identical to d over dx f of x. Sometimes we will use one notation, sometimes we will use the other. With that understood, let's take the derivative of some more polynomials. Again, using the power rule, the derivative of x cubed is 3x squared. The derivative of x to the fourth is 4x cubed. This pattern will continue for any exponent. Now let's take the derivative of 3x to the fourth. As we are bringing this 4 down here, we must multiply by the 3 that is already there, so we get 12x cubed. Another way of explaining this is by mentioning the constant multiple rule, which says that the quantity cf prime equals c times f prime. If we are taking the derivative of some function that is being multiplied by some constant, this will be the same as multiplying the constant times the derivative of the function. So we can just pull the constant out here. Using this to look at the previous example, the derivative of 3x to the fourth, we can pull the 3 out, take the derivative of x to the fourth to get 4x cubed, and then we simply multiply by the 3 that we pulled out before, and we get the same answer that we already had. So however we think about it, when taking a derivative, the exponent that we pull down front must multiply any existing coefficient. Now, what about polynomials with multiple terms? Actually, this will be no problem due to the sum rule. This says that the derivative of the quantity f of x plus g of x will be equal to the derivative of f of x plus the derivative of g of x, or more simply, f plus g quantity prime equals f prime plus g prime. Similarly, there is the difference rule, which works just like the sum rule, stating that f minus g quantity prime equals f prime minus g prime. That means that no matter how many terms are in a polynomial, we will just take the derivative of one term at a time. So for x to the sixth plus 2x to the fourth minus 3x squared plus 2, we can just go from left to right to get 6x to the fifth plus 8x cubed minus 6x. Don't forget that the 2 will go away, as it's a constant. So as long as we know the power rule, taking the derivative of any polynomial in standard form is actually quite trivial. Let's try just one more for practice. Try x to the 8th minus 5x to the 5th plus 11x cubed minus 2x. Again, moving left to right, we get 8x to the 7th minus 25x to the fourth plus 33x squared minus 2. Now, with the power rule under our belts, let's try something a little trickier. What about the derivative of a product of functions? Unfortunately, this is not as simple as just the product of the two derivatives. In other words, fg quantity prime is not equal to f prime times g prime. Instead, we have to use the product rule. This says that the derivative of f of x times g of x is equal to f of x times g prime of x plus g of x times f prime of x. Or more simply, fg quantity prime equals fg prime plus g f prime. We can even verify that this works by looking at x squared. We know the derivative is 2x, but say we turn this into x times x and apply the product rule. X times the derivative of x is simply x, and the derivative of x times x is also x. So we add them together to get 2x, and we can see that this works just as expected. Let's try this with some other functions. What is the derivative of x cubed times 2x? Well, first, let's leave the first function alone and take the derivative of the second. The derivative of 2x is 2, so we get 2x cubed. Now, let's take the derivative of the first function and leave the second one alone. That will be 3x squared times the 2x that we didn't touch, and that will be 6x cubed. Adding them up, we get 8x cubed. As we can see, this is not simply the product of the derivatives of each function. We had to use the product rule, and if we had simply multiplied these two original terms together to get 2x to the fourth, the power rule would have given us the same result, 8x cubed. Let's try one more. Find the derivative of 3x to the fourth times 5x squared. We can use precisely the same algorithm every time, so let's leave the first function alone and take the derivative of the second to get 10x, which gives a product of 30x to the fifth. Then we take the derivative of the first to get 12x cubed and leave the second function alone, which then multiply to give 60x to the fifth. Adding them together, we get 90x to the fifth. Again, this agrees with the answer we would get if we were to multiply the original terms together and use the power rule. Later, we will see plenty of functions where we can't just multiply these terms together, making the product rule absolutely necessary. So as long as we can memorize the product rule, which is fairly simple, it's just a matter of taking a couple of simple derivatives, followed by some multiplication and addition. Lastly, what about the derivative of a quotient of functions? Say we want to find the derivative of f of x over g of x. To do this, we need the quotient rule, and unfortunately, this is not an exact parallel of the product rule. This is a different rule that should also be memorized. To find the derivative of f of x over g of x, we find g of x times f prime of x minus f of x times g prime of x, and all of that will be over g of x quantity squared. Again, more simply, f over g quantity prime equals gf prime minus fg prime all over g squared. Make note that for the product rule, the order of the terms didn't matter, since it involved a sum. But for the quotient rule, it will matter. It must be g times f prime minus f times g prime. If you switch this, you will get incorrect answers. And we also can't forget the g of x quantity squared on the bottom. Don't worry, you will memorize this quite easily. Let's try an example. What about the derivative of x squared plus 1 over x plus 2? First, let's set up the expression, making sure to put everything in the correct place. Then, let's evaluate these two derivatives. For the first, we get 2x, and for the other, we get 1. Now we can multiply these terms, distribute this negative sign, and simplify, and expand the denominator if we wish to get x squared plus 4x minus 1 over x squared plus 4x plus 4, which can be left as is. So these are the basic algorithms we will use in order to take the derivatives of functions. We will expand on them as we go, finding that when using the power rule, this exponent can be a negative integer or even a non-integer, but the rules don't really change. And even when products or quotients get more complicated, it's not really any harder, just more steps, and therefore more opportunities to make a mistake. But if we practice and become diligent, we will find that it's not too difficult to take the derivative of any polynomial. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.